Here there was a gate where the sun rose on the winter solstice, and another gate was over there where the sun rose on the summer solstice.
And what's really amazing about this is it was 2,500 years before Stonehenge.
Yet there's a striking connection between this henge and the Nebra star disk. The angle formed between the midsummer and midwinter sunrise is 82 degrees. Exactly the same angle as the horizon lines marked on the Nebra disk. But that's not surprising, because although 3,500 years separate this Neolithic henge and the Bronze Age disk, both are marking the same magical events of midsummer's and midwinter's day. But whoever used this disk had much more than knowledge of the heavens in their hands.
The main point is not that it is a practical instrument. It's a symbol of knowledge, and it's a magic instrument. Mm-hmm. People who knew everything about the stars knew also everything about magic and religion.
So the Nebra disk was also a sacred magical tool for Bronze Age priests. It seems to me that part of its power was that it contained knowledge that most people could not have understood. Just like today's scientists and computer wizards, knowledge is magic.
It was definitely magic to the simple farmer, but it might have been some kind of science to the educated priest. So both mixed, magic to the simple people, science to the priest.
The same as today, really.
Same as today, you're right. Yeah.
Archaeologists can only guess at the identity of the people who made this disc 3,600 years ago. But where can I find evidence of the people who knew how to use this disc and wield its power? The actual magicians of this ancient world. From the earliest times, our Stone Age ancestors saw the sun, moon, and stars as enchanted. In the Bronze Age, a new underworld magic was forged. These two worlds then combined into a powerful magical force. Where can I find evidence of the ancient wizard priests who, to ordinary people, seem to have been in possession of this magic?
To do that, I've come to Denmark to see the otherworldly goods of a real Bronze Age magician.
The bogs of Denmark have preserved many clues to the daily life and beliefs of the Bronze Age. Here, magic had a clear purpose. In an uncertain world, magical rituals were deemed necessary to honor the rising sun every day.
The sun was a symbol of all essential cosmic powers of the world. The sun was simply everything.
If magic here was about controlling natural forces, then who were the magicians? The clues may lie in the contents of this Bronze Age grave. Here, there was no body. But what had survived was a medical pouch with an extraordinary range of objects. They included tweezers, hawk's claws, and snake's tails.
It's a bit like, you know, Shakespeare's Macbeth, you know, I have Newton. It's very much like a witchcraft.
Yes, that's really things you would put into Edward's brew.
Were they practical or symbolic? We can only speculate as to the purpose of these sacred objects.
The snake tail is related to the earth. The claw of the hawk is related to the sky. The conch is related to the sea. All these elements brought together could be used for carry out magic in relation to the notions of the bias of the sun, the sun cut.
There was one more clue that would give me a picture of this magician. Along with the tools of his trade was a fragment of his magical costume.
In the grave was found, reasonably well preserved, a little tongue of woolen textiles.
So like a loincloth sort of?
Yes, something like that, but with a little tongue covering your
private parts.
Yes.
What could be the purpose of this odd-shaped piece of fabric? All we do know is that the very same costume appears on a set of miniature Bronze Age figures.
There's this special dress with a tongue here in front and the back, and then he is wearing horned helmets.
And here we have identical full-size versions of both those miniature horned helmets and ceremonial axes.
We call them a cult axe because they have no practical use whatsoever.
It hasn't even got an edge on it.
No, no.
So the tiny bronze figures represent real people and real ceremonies. Our magician in the grave was a priest in the cult of the sun. His job was to keep the sun rising in the sky, because in the Bronze Age, magic and religion were one and the same.
What was the source of his magical power, do you think?
Well, the source was that he had an essential knowledge of the voyage of the sun, of the secrets of cosmos. And as we all know, knowledge is power, but secret knowledge is even more power.
Secret power.
Makes you even more powerful.
Makes you a magician.
Yes, exactly.
I wonder if this magic still works today.
So it still hasn't come out. But it's clearing up a bit.
A little bit.
Another 10 minutes.
Secret knowledge was the source of power for the wizard priests of Denmark. Magicians dressed to impress. Putting on a good show was part of pagan magic, just like stage entertainers do today. But what is a wizard without a magic hat? It was here in Germany in the late Bronze Age that the knowledge of the sun and the moon and the power of the wizard priests combined to produce one of the most remarkable objects of pagan times. For over a century, this Bronze Age treasure lay in museum vaults. This is one of four similar objects. All are over 3,000 years old. It was skillfully made from a single piece of gold. But how this was achieved remains a mystery. Its original purpose has baffled archaeologists for decades, until now.
But what exactly is it?
Yeah, it's a hat, a wizard's hat, you can say. A hat for a priest. It's Bronze Age time, about 3,000 years old.
This Bronze Age wizard's hat is embossed with symbols of the sun, moon and stars.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Dr. Mengen is convinced he has solved the mystery of what these symbols mean.
16, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19.
There are 1,739 sun and moon symbols. Dr. Mengen believes they are a kind of secret code, something astronomers today call the Metonic Cycle. It's a 19-year calendar that enables the movements of the sun and moon to be calculated years in advance.
This is a sort of calendar where the priest or the wizard could count the sun years, the sun months, and the moon months.
The Bronze Age wizards not only controlled the sun with magical rituals, with this hat they could predict its movements and therefore predict the future. They were the time lords of their society.
For he knew about the future and the past, and he was a very mighty person in the Bronze Age community.
For thousands of years, festivals have been connected with the natural cycles of the sun and moon. Fertility, death, and rebirth were all celebrated in the Earth's natural calendar. The wizards who controlled these festivals controlled people's lives.
So is this why you call it a wizard's hat, because it contains all this magical knowledge?
Yes.
Well, he must have had a big head.
Yes.
Can you put it on, or?
Yes, I can do this, I can try it.
Yeah, put it on my head.
Well, it fits you perfectly. So how does it feel to wear the hat?
Yeah, quite uncommon, but it's very interesting that you have the feeling that the strength of the stars or the sun is coming through the point of the head and is concentrating in your brain.
Because in English we say to put your thinking cap on, but this is a little bit more than a cap, isn't it?
You can try it.
Do you want to crown me?
Yeah. So, but maybe your head is smaller than mine.
I think my head's bigger. Yes.
Much more bigger. Oh, it's a British head.
Was the influence of...